time for The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, with, from real people, Bill Rafferty. From Dallas, Fern Fitzgerald. From Search for Tomorrow, Rod Arrants. Marcia Wallace. Marty Cohen. And the stars of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Bravo,
bravo.
Bravissimo.
Oh, all right. I think it's going to be a wonderful Friday, and we're all going to be glad to get out of here, aren't we?
Good
audience this time. I can tell it's an excellent comedy
crowd.
Good audience.
Yes.
I got to tell you something. Wait a minute. He said backstage. Wait a minute.
We'll get
you
that
guys.
Fixed in just
hold
a minute.
Hold it, wait a minute. I'll push it.
A little
get
silly
it.
Putty.
That's it, fellas. No, yes, there was. He said backstage, look, when I go out, I bet the applause is going to die down. But you were wrong. They applauded for you more than for anybody else. They like him better than they like the rest of you.
Because we're leaving. That's
sick crowd.
Thanks,
Jayne.
What's
I might as well leave. There's no reason.
Oh, wait, I was only kidding. A little joke.
Oh. Well.
Do you want us to stay or do you want us to go?
You actors are...
You go,
too
John.
Sensitive.
You
know? Too sensitive.
Really?
Right. Are you feeling okay?
I feel great.
She feels fine. Yeah.
It's a all shame right. about her body, though.
It is too bad about her body.
I just hope she doesn't get a chest cold, you know?
Yes. Mm-hmm. We're going to send her to New Hampshire next year to build her up some summer camp to do something about her body.
Where'd you go?
At least she's a good sport and a nice person.
Thank you,
for being so unattractive.
Right. She's got Let's say hello to our two players over here. We have Sylvia Olson and Gary Berberet. Okay.
Don't stutter,
Jim. I want to get acquainted with both of them. So let's find out first about Sylvia. Hi.
Hi. I'm married to Jeff. He's an aspiring author, and we live in Sparks, Nevada with our four children, Mercy, Jasmine, Bryson, and Coco. Wow. And I work for a local modeling agency.
Here in New York? I mean, here in New York. See where my mind is.
No, in Reno.
In Reno?
Yes.
Oh, Sparks is near Reno?
Yes, right next to it.
I've been through Sparks once or twice. I used to drive up to Wyoming. Well, nice to have you with us, Sylvia. Gary, let's hear about you, please.
Well, Gene, I'm a promotions man. I work for a large cable television station here in Burbank.
Yeah.
I love the beach, and I love to dabble in acting part-time in community theater.
There's no such thing as dabbling in acting.
I give it my best shot.
You give it your best shot. All right. I hope you'll give it your best shot here, too. In the match game, we'll play three rounds. The winner will go on to challenge the returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Sylvia won the toss. We'll ask you to go first.
A, please.
All right. We're off and running. Well, we're off.
We're off.
Big Bertha said.
Big Bertha. Yeah.
She said, I can't find a bra big enough to fit me. So instead, I wear two blanks tied together. I got a good one.
Tell me. What is it?
I can't tell you. It's against the rules. And away we go.
Okay, go away.
All right.
Where'd she go?
Fern.
Yes?
Ready, go. Sylvia. Big Bertha said, I can't find a bra big enough to fit me, so instead I wear two blanks tied together.
Bowls.
bowls.
I guess those kids won't be eating much this week.
Hold on a minute.
All I could see was this.
If you get a 2-quart mixing bowl, it would be about so big. It would be terrific. She said bowls.
Bowls.
Not that anybody over here is going to say it.
Just never know.
I've got to ask you anyway, Rod.
All right. Oh, well, it's a lofty concept. Parachutes.
Parachutes.
Parachutes?
All right.
You know how I like to inject a little human interest here. Now, yes. Not off, but I never care.
Yes.
I once was on the dating game years ago, and I won a trip to Sparks, Nevada. I swear to God, I did. But I did not go to Sparks, Nevada. Bachelor number one went with bachelor number two. So I'll always think kindly of Sparks.
Always now a bridesmaid, never.
Yes, I suppose you want an answer now.
I suppose so.
Helmets.
Helmets! Good!
That's good.
Now, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Have you ever seen a motorcycle helmet? It's about so big, it'd be perfect for Big Bertha. It'd go right... never mind.
Watch yes. it.
Well, I'm a very artistic fellow. I'm an opera fan, and I went for hubcaps.
Hubcaps!
That made all the sense in the world, right?
Thank you.
You can't argue with logic like that.
Thank you.
This made sense.
As long as it wasn't a VW hubcap, you're okay. John?
I don't get it.
Well, I had a great answer that I wrote down and crossed out because it was both impossible. They weren't big enough, and it was also too Jewish. Yarmulkes.
Yeah. Then you cross that out, and you put
lampshades. But lamp I crossed that out and lit up the room with lampshades.
That's good.
Which was equally wrong.
Okay. Here comes the supreme authority.
This isn't any better. Well, now, let me explain this.
Nope.
These are cut in half. Beach balls.
Oh, yeah. They're good. There's about so round.
Thank you, friends. Thank you.
She could easily have said that. Beach balls cut in half. Right. It's on the tip of her tongue.
Bowls is what she said, Marty.
Well, I'm so sure that I'm going to get booed for this answer because if it was too ethnic for John, it's too ethnic for me. I said yarmulke. Oh. So.
Yarmulke. Ready, Gary?
Ready.
All right, here we go. Barney said, I just figured out why my inflatable girl doll is getting so fat.
Why?
I came home early last night and caught her sucking the air out of a blank. Because you're a wonderful person.
She knew.
The world loves you.
Want to go to the Encino Arms afterwards?
The Encino Arms. It's you and me.
Memories.
It sure do.
The leg there.
Encino, yes.
You have to bring it.
Now that she's abandoned
yes.
me, it's going to be you and me, baby.
That's
to the
right.
motel in Encino. Saturday night. Ready,
good.
Gary?
No.
No?
Watch.
You know what these inflatable dolls look like, don't you? You've seen them in magazines and stuff like that. I've never seen one in person, but... Barney said, I just figured out why my inflatable girl doll is getting so fat. I came home early last night and caught her sucking the air out of a blank.
A banana?
This guy doesn't know how to play the game. How'd he get on the show?
I'm shocked.
Something with air in it, Gary.
That's why banana doesn't
tell him something with air in it.
I'll tell you something. Gary, you need, it's time for your medication. Vacuum cleaner.
Vacuum cleaner. Anything with air in it. All right.
I like the whole idea of this. It's a visual answer. Just imagine a tire.
A tire.
I've been cheered.
You're going to have to start testing them a little earlier, Gene, before you let them in here. You know what I mean?
Right.
But great minds think alike. Marcia and I.
Martha.
Martha's
tires. Martha Washington. You'll see her on a series this week.
Martha Wallace, it's great to have you with us.
Most personal.
Maybe we can break the set and let Gary enter again.
Rod LaRock.
This is the definitive answer. Blimp.
Blimp.
Got air in it. So far, we had four things with air in it and one banana. Fern?
I said banana.
What?
No, limp. I said blimp.
Limp is what she said. All right.
The inflatable doll thought she was eating a donut. She sucked the air out of an inner tube.
Inner tube. Oh,
that's good.
Okay. There's round one. 0-0 the score. We're going to go on with round two anyway, right after this. Here we go with round two. Since the score is tied, she went first last time. Gary, we ask you to go first this time.
I'll try A, please.
All right.
In here, I dropped it.
Certainly can't do any worse with this one than you did. Some people with bad backs like to hang by their ankles. but not Weird Willie. Uh-uh. To make his back feel better, he hangs by his blank.
That's funny.
Can't say that.
We're upward.
Ready, Rod. Gary, mm-hmm. Some people with bad backs like to hang by their ankles. Not Weird Willie. To make his back feel better, he hangs by his blank.
Toes?
Why don't we just give her the money now?
Yes.
Toes. See, that would be almost like hanging by your ankles, wouldn't it?
Oh, who asked you?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just an intermediary here. Rod, what do you say?
It rhymes, but I'm no more proud of it than a banana. Nose.
Well, nose is good. Somewhere the opposite of ankles.
Harry doesn't like it.
All right.
You got me ruffled. This
really?
Is, she's not here yet, but this is sort of the Jayne Kennedy Memorial answer. She'll be out later. Belt?
Belt.
I know.
Hang size belt.
Oh. I agree.
It's a double.
For once, I agree. Go ahead.
Boom.
Go ahead. Good. More. More. Thank
yes.
you. I needed
yes.
that.
I told you in an earlier episode that I went to St. Dominic's of Abuse as a young man, so I put down thumbs.
Hang by your thumbs.
Good.
That's another good one.
It was Weird Willie, right?
Yeah.
All right, to make his back feel better, he hangs by his...
Gary, I was really sure you were going to say banana on this one. But I didn't. I said ears.
All right. No toes, Gary. Fern?
Did they like ears? Because that's what I said.
You said ears.
I like it better when
Thank
you say
Thank you, friends.
I think he hangs
Marty?
By his... I think he hangs by his Mercy, Bryson, Jasmine, and Coco. Which is, as I know. No, Weird Willie was really weird and into pain. He liked to hang by his chest hairs.
Aha! That's a good one.
Very good.
Now, Sylvia, this is yours.
Sure. Sure.
That's a career in the making.
Here we go. Jacques Cousteau said...
Jacques. What did
Jacques
he say?
Jacques Cousteau said, it was easy to go from under the ocean to working in Hollywood. After all, I am used to dealing with blanks. You got it.
I lost my little...
Okay, Rod.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. All right, Sylvia. Jacques Cousteau said it was easy to go from under the ocean to working in Hollywood. After all, I am used to dealing with blanks.
Fish.
Fish.
Sylvia, try to stretch a little, okay?
All right.
Stop Come hanging out with Gary.
Here we go, Ron.
I said man-eating sharks.
Sharks.
Yeah. Man-eating sharks.
You understand That's it okay. now, don't you?
Yes.
Apropos of Jacques Cousteau, I'm certified. I'm certifiable, too, but I'm a certified scuba diver, yes. You should
Are you?
See me with my tanks.
Oh, I'd love to see your tanks.
I have been down 125 feet.
Have you really?
And came right back up.
The jolly green
Sharks.
Tank. Sharks it is. Yes, sir?
Show business agents, sharks.
Sharks. Another shark?
The definitive answer, shark.
There it is.
Jaws.
Right. Worried about your agent?
I am used to hanging by my Mercy, Jasmine, Coco, and Bryson. No, of course we said sharks. As
All right. Said Six of those. No score. No score. Third and final round after this. We'll score. Coming up. Now, since it's still tied and he went first last time, Sylvia, you go first this time.
A, please.
All right. A is what she asked for, and that's what she gets. Little Herbie said...
What did he say?
He said, we're so poor. Oh. All my clothes are hand-me-downs from my brother. And little weird Wally said, that's nothing. All my hand-me-downs are from my blank. Here we go. Sylvia. Little Herbie said, we're so poor, all my clothes are hand-me-downs from my brother. And little weird Wally said, that's nothing. All my hand-me-downs are from my blank.
Sister.
She said sister. Yeah.
What?
A Well, the audience seemed to approve of that one.
I noticed that.
I think maybe we're finally getting a little progress here, if you said sister.
Well, I said banana. No, I didn't. Sister!
And if I didn't say sister, what are you going to do about it? Smack me, huh?
Yeah.
Push me around?
Yeah.
Okay,
you'd
good.
Love it.
Sister.
All right.
I was thinking that California connection myself. Sister!
All right, John.
Now listen, sister, I love tonight.
Take me to your sister. All right. Another one from Fern.
I said hand-me-downs from Jasmine and Coco.
Sisters.
All right, the challenge now is to catch up. Mm-hmm. You can tie it by matching all six stars, Gary. Here it is. Andy Granatelli really loves his STP. Every morning, he pours it in his blank.
Every morning.
Every morning, he pours it in his blank.
Right.
Andy Granatelli. Here we go. Gary. Andy Granatelli really loves his STP. Every morning, he pours it in his blank.
His coffee.
That's good, Gary.
Making a comeback.
Another comeback.
Gary finally got one. What do you say?
I say coffee.
All right.
I personally, you'd like to have a banana in my coffee.
All right. That's two.
Fill it to the rim with coffee. All
right. Well. If we end up in a tie, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
And restaurantees, draw four, that's coffee.
6-4, the score. Fern.
Oh, Fern.
It's up to you, Fern.
Fern, it's all up to you.
You were doing so well, Fern.
I'm sorry, Gary.
You were
Gary.
Doing so well.
That's okay. Cereal. Cereal. You win the game. Go on down. Right on this spot, if you would, please. I'll get to you in a moment. Gary, it was a pleasure to meet you.
It's been fun,
thanks. A lot of gifts to you from the match game. Gary Berberet, ladies and gentlemen. Listen, time now to switch to Hollywood Squares. Here comes the rest of our set. We'll bring on three more celebrities. John and I will trade places. And we've got lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back. A member of our studio audience will receive Whirlpool's No Frost French Door Refrigerator with Bottom Freezer. Offers spacious shelf capacity, generous fresh food compartment, porcelain on steel interior, and no fingerprint doors, furnished by Whirlpool. And now it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares, power, wheel, from one day at a time, Michael Lembeck. From Dukes of Hazzard, Sorrell, Booke, Jayne Kennedy, and taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bowman.
All right, we'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares. Come with us.
And now, John Bowman at the Hollywood Square.
Hey, Mercy Grayson, Jasmine and Coco. Mama
Grayson, Jasmine,
made it through match game into Hollywood Squares. And we have three new celebrities. Jayne Kennedy.
Hello, how are you?
Sorrell Booke. And Michael Lembeck.
Hello, John. Hello, everybody. Good Friday to you all.
Jayne Kennedy.
Yes.
You have a series of records and a general program called Love the, Your Body. Is that
exercise.
Correct?
Yes. I have the two albums, one intermediate, one advanced, and a video, and a syndicated radio show on exercise. It's very good.
Love Your Body.
Yeah.
We'll love your body.
Body. Let's go play Hollywood Squares while we're not in trouble. We will reintroduce ourselves to our defending champ. Her name is Bethany Barden. She was a spec 4 yesterday. She may soon be a spec 5. She won 5 and has a total of $6,075. Ah, that was a fun day.
Sure was.
Any thoughts about what you might do with that kind of money?
No.
Probably don't want to think about it until you're through.
Right. And I'm not.
Well, it was a thought.
I have some ideas from over there. But you may not be through yet because you're going to play Hollywood Squares at least one more time. Whoever is ahead at the Time's Up bell goes on to play Supermatch, and that can be worth up to 30,000 smackaroos. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Bethany, start us off.
Marcia, please.
Miss Wallace.
Mr. Bauman.
Can your eyes become sunburned? Or are they protected by your tears?
Oh, no. I think you can scorch them suckers. They get awfully sore. Oh, you mean actually burned, though. You mean burned as in red? Do I get added info on this? Probably not.
No, that's about it.
If you ramble enough, sometimes an inspiration comes.
Not this time.
Not this time.
No.
You know, they are protected by your tears. They can get awfully sore, but they can't get burned. Yes, they can. That's what I like. A woman with conviction. Yes.
She says.
Get burned. Yes, they can.
Martha, Marcia.
I got you.
It's rubbing off on me. Definitively has said that they are protected by your tears.
No, I changed my mind.
Oh, you changed it back again. Okay. Sorry.
They can be burned.
She says they can become sunburned. Agree or disagree, Bethany?
I agree.
They can get sunburned. You're right to agree. Thank you so much. You get the square and you're off to a good start. Sylvia, your move. Pick a star for an O.
Jayne, please.
Jayne Kennedy. A Parisian woman is deeply involved in le footing.
Le footing?
Right.
Spell it.
F-O-T-T-ing.
Oh, okay.
Is she jogging or painting her toenails?
Le footing.
Oui.
Well, it sounds like it's something of an American adaptation. And since we started that whole thing, I think we started it here in the States with jogging. Let's say it's jogging. Le footing.
Agree or disagree, Sylvia?
I disagree.
It is jogging. Yeah! You should have agreed with Jayne. Good for you, Jayne, but not so good for Sylvia. Her opponent gets that square. Bethany.
Marty, your move. The win, please.
Feisty Cohen for the first game. Marty. According to a University of California study.
Yes.
Who's more likely to suffer from a heart attack? A pig who jogs?
Is it kosher?
Doesn't even have to be French. Or a pig who just rolls around in the mud?
There's a guy who sits in an office and thinks of these questions.
And gets paid.
A pig who jogs or a pig who rolls around in the mud? Which one is more likely to suffer from a heart attack?
Right.
Neither. They don't suffer. They die fast. Oh. I would say that the pig that rolls around in the mud is more likely to suffer a heart attack because it gets no exercise, makes a little hog of itself.
Agree or disagree, Bethany, for the first game?
I'll disagree.
More likely to suffer from a heart attack? A pig who just rolls around in the mud. You should have agreed with Marty, and your opponent gets
things.
That square and blocks you.
Oh, Bethany.
Sylvia, new life for you. You almost had a heart attack on that question, but you're still in the game. Pick a star for an O.
Jayne, please.
Mr. Rayburn.
Yes, sir.
In the Soviet Union, can you go to the store and buy dog food? Or is there no such thing?
I haven't been there. And just on general principle, I'm not going because I don't want to give them any American dollars and help their balance of trade. That's the way I feel about it.
All right.
Next question. No, I don't know. They have so much trouble getting hard goods and foodstuffs, and there are long lines for people to buy food to eat. I would think it would be impossible to get dog food.
Agree or disagree, Sylvia?
I agree.
There is no such thing. Yes, it is impossible to get dog food. You're right to agree. You get the square. Well done. We have a 50-50 game. It is more than so-so. We'll be back to find out its conclusion after this.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
X-X-O. Oh. Just figuring out the game. It's your move, Bethany. You are playing X. Pick a star.
Fern to block, please.
All right. You missed this one. The challenger.
Thanks.
Wins the first game.
Have a little faith in me, John. You missed this one.
Don't look to your left, Fern. You'll be okay. What's longer, the number of years... Oh, good. You're on Dallas. This is good for you.
Oh, God.
What is longer, the number of years J.R. Ewing has been on TV or the lifespan of a louse?
Well, I'm 31.
The lifespan of a louse? Well, I hope that it's JR, even though JR is a louse. So it's really the same thing, but I'm going to go with JR.
Okay. She says JR Ewing has been on TV longer number of years than a louse lives. Agree or disagree, Bethany? To block.
I agree.
It is the time J.R. Ewing has been on TV. Yes. Rather complicated wording, but you're right to agree. You get the square. You do block. The average louse lives just 1 month.
Oh, I'm dying to know that. 1 month.
Sylvia, your move.
Sorrell to block, please.
Okay. Sorrell.
The average
other way.
Louse lives only a month.
The other Sorrell, guys. What? There's something unusual in that your square wasn't flashing. That's all. Oh. There we go. Stop flashing now, Sorrell. There is something unusual in the ground underneath Beverly Hills High School.
Yeah.
Is it oil? Or is that where the founder of Beverly Hills is buried?
Well, you know, I passed there. In fact, I looked down on there from a building where my doctor has his office. And I see an oil well, or something that looks like an oil well. May not be an oil well, by the way.
But so you think it's...
But I do think it's oil, then.
He thinks there's oil.
Yes, I have. I saw no mausoleum.
He thinks there's oil underneath Beverly Hills High School. Do you think so, to block?
I disagree.
There is oil underneath Beverly Hills High School. You should have agreed with Sorrell. Your opponent gets a square and wins the first game. So, there is oil beneath Beverly Hills High School. The rich get richer, and that applies to you, Bethany Barden. You
That's
have $200
good.
So far, $50 for your opponent, but we've got plenty of time. Sweep the X's and O's off of the board. We will move on to a $200 game, and you get to start, Mrs. Olson.
Marcia, please.
Marcia Wallace. Which is a better exercise for your middle back, Marcia?
I have a great back, by the way. It's my best feature, unfortunately.
You have nice shoulders.
It is, it is.
But which is a better exercise for your middle back? Is it making love or bowling?
You're both about the same frequency, don't you?
Well, now, let me see. I have a trophy.
Can you answer this before you kill Marty?
For bowling. That bowling is real good for you, hon.
She
says. Well, the other is too. Very good.
But you're saying bowling is better
bowling
exercise for your middle back.
Back.
Right. Agree or disagree, Sylvia?
I disagree.
Making love is better exercise for your middle back. Marcia, you just didn't know, I guess, huh?
Well, I told you, bowling's my specialty.
She got the first square. Your move, Bethany, for an X.
Jayne, please.
Jayne Rayburn.
Yes.
You're a dentist, and you're treating your first beaver.
Really?
When he opens his mouth, what color will his front teeth be? White, black, or orange?
I suppose, well, black will rule out right away. Orange is a possibility because of the sap, the moisture in the trees. White, he doesn't see his periodontist often enough, so they can't be white. I'd say yellow or orange or whatever that was. Orange.
You guys are trying to be that logical about a beaver and a dentist.
Yeah.
He says that the beaver has orange teeth. Agree or disagree, Bethany?
I agree.
A beaver has orange teeth. You're perfectly right. He reasoned it out. Perfectly right to agree. You get the square. Mrs. Olson, your move for an O.
Bill, please.
Okay,
just
Bill Rafferty.
Bill. Just Bill.
Their nicknames are Corky and Sissy. Are they Donnie and Marie Osmond or Vice President George Bush and his wife?
Oh, I guess when they want to get out on a Friday night for a fling, they like to loosen up a little bit, so I'm going to go with the Vice President and his wife.
Vice President Corky Sissy.
He says, Vice President Corky Bush and Sissy Bush. Agree or disagree, Sylvia?
I'll agree.
Their nicknames are Corky and Sissy. They are Donnie and Marie. You should have disagreed with Bill. Your opponent gets that square. Golly, we're in the middle of a $200 game, and we're going to be right back to finish it after these messages. Don't miss it. $250 for the champ, $75 for the challenger, but it's a $200 game, and we got plenty of time. So nothing is decided. Bethany Barton, your move.
Marty, please.
Mr. Cohen.
Yes, sir.
What kind of canoe is easier to maneuver? What kind of canoe is easier to maneuver? One with a flat bottom? One with a flat bottom or a round bottom?
I don't know.
What kind of a canoe is easier to maneuver?
Yeah.
The flat bottom canoe will, because I majored in boatiology. I had a minor in one oar in the water, and the flat bottom boat is not maneuverable because it'll just float around like a little duck in your bathtub. But the round bottom boat you can guide.
He says round bottom canoe is easier to maneuver. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
A round bottom canoe is easier to maneuver. You are right. Agree. You get the square.
I don't know about canoes.
Sylvia, pick a star.
I'll take Michael to block, please.
All right.
I'm ready.
You missed this one. It's a pretty big lead for Bethany.
Okay, then.
Michael Lembeck, according to the New York Department of Health, more New Yorkers are bitten by dogs than by anything else. But who inflicts the second highest number of bites?
Mayor Kutch.
Is it squirrels or people?
I don't believe these questions. Did you say New York or Manhattan?
We understand each other. That's important.
The second leading bite thing.
And it's all of New York.
Bite thing. I abstain from this question.
It's either squirrels or people.
Squirrels or people. I'm going to say people. Because squirrels could have diseases, and we'd hear about that. I'll say people.
To block, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
Second highest number of bites? People.
Yeah.
Right, to agree. Yeah. You get the square, you do block. I love New York. I haven't had a bite in weeks, right? That's what the guy says in Central Park. So I bit him. Bethany, your move.
Fern to win, please.
Mm-hmm.
Fern,
she couldn't block you there.
Fern to win. No pressure, Fern.
Fern Fitzgerald, do people in prison really make license plates, or is that a myth?
Marty, didn't you tell me that you were making license plates? They definitely make license plates. Oh, yes, they do a lot of things. They write Marty's jokes, and they make license plates. Touché, my dear, touché.
I have a feeling we're lucky it's Friday. Bethany, she says people in prison really do make license plates. Agree or disagree for the game?
I agree.
People in prison really do make license plates, and you really do get the square, and you really do win the game. Of all the shenanigans, you managed to complete the game, and you got a pretty big lead. $500 to $100, but there's still time. Clear the board, move on to the next game. It's worth $300. If we keep it moving, we got a shot. Sylvia, pick a star.
Marcia, please.
Marcia Wallace.
Yeah.
According to the book, How to Clean Everything, will your bra fit better if you iron it after every washing? Or should you just put it on wrinkled?
She don't wear one.
Why? Jayne.
What?
How do you know?
I'm a fan. Well, iron your bra after every washing or just put it on wrinkled?
Yeah. Will it fit better?
Well, in my case, ironing would fit better. But I think...
I thought those were natural wrinkles.
I think you know that. Ironing, that's heat. It's not good. I never liked him. Put it on wrinkled because you don't need all that heat on. It's not good for them threads.
So you should just put it on wrinkled. Agree or disagree, Sylvia?
I agree.
You should just put it on wrinkled. You're right to agree, and you get the first square of this game. Where would you like to place an X, Spec 4?
Jayne, please.
Jayne Rayburn.
Jayne who? Is he here?
Yeah. Jayne, you play tennis with friends almost every day.
Right.
Sure.
But you've just found out that you're pregnant. To the technical explanation of this one.
Right. Wasn't the racket,
I wasn't around anyway.
Now, should you stop? Orange, yeah. Should you stop immediately? Or can you just keep on swinging?
You mean I'm in my first month?
Yeah, you just found out that you're pregnant.
Yes. Well, there is no reason to stop unless you're really an inept player and you're apt to not protect your body with the racket and get hit by the tennis ball, and that would be dangerous. That would be the only dangerous part of it. But as far as the exercise is concerned, it's good for you in the early part of the pregnancy. Sooner or later, you have to stop.
He says you can just keep on swinging. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You can just keep on swinging. You're right to agree. And you get the square. Time is up. She has done it once again. Second day in a row. Got two for a hit for you. $525. Bethany Martin, congratulations. And she has made her way over to join Jean Rayburn. Gets set for a shot at the big money once again. Sylvia? You did pretty well. She's a good champ. She's a good player. You let her get a little bit too far ahead, but you are leaving here with $125. Thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. It's been really fun.
Gene, team.
Okay, John. Well, here we are, Bethany, it's her second day. We'll be back with her and the stars. Going to go with the big money right after this. And now, here to play the super match is Jean Rayburn. Here we go. This is her second day up here. She knows it's possible to win up to $30,000, and we all wish her well, don't we?
Yes.
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 All right, let's see a member of the United States Armed Forces win some money here.
Spec four.
Certainly costs us enough taxpayers enough to keep them in uniform, doesn't it? All right, here we go. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. X blank. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, it's $1,000. For the second, $500. For the third, $250. Now, any three of the stars can offer some assistance. If you look them over, those who have a bright look in their eyes are the ones who have answers. Those who look glazed are hiding their eyes.
Those with orange teeth are beavers.
Right.
John, please.
X-ray.
X-ray.
Ray.
All right.
I changed my mind.
Okay, Marcia.
X marks the spot.
Oh, you look at mine.
X marks the spot.
Okay.
You want Marty?
I'm going to go with Fern this time.
Sure, Marty doesn't know anything. X-rated.
X-rated.
That's what I was going to say. X-rated.
Which Marty is.
But I've X-rated.
Y-U-I-O.
X marks the spot and X-ray.
You may have saved your
You choose one of those, or if you think there's a better one than that, you'll say that.
I don't know. The audience went with rated, so I'll go with rated.
You've influenced her audience. Hold everything.
A cheap and tawdry audience.
If she blows the money, it's your fault.
True.
If she loses the money, it's your fault because she was influenced by your applause. Now we'll find out. Let's go down to the bottom there and reveal the $250 response. X-ray is John's answer. All right, you've got one of their three. The $500 response says, X marks the spot. You got two of the three there. It looks good for you, and you too, audience. Here we go. X-ray. You got it. There's your $1,000.
See, wow. You didn't go for it again?
I was going to say rated.
Now it's time for you to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, the star will reveal the hidden number. And we'll multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. It'll be a 10, a 20, or a 30. In any case, you know, it's still pretty good. But we do hope you get the 30. We haven't had one in quite a while. Now pick a 30.
Any 30.
John, again, please.
John, she thinks you have the 30. Ready,
I hope
set,
to be 30.
Go.
Blow it now, John.
Don't be nervous, John.
Him.
Yeah.
Me.
You're not nervous. She says, him, me. No, nobody's nervous. Good luck to you. Here we go. Air blank. A-I-R blank. No help from the audience. If we hear an answer, we got to throw it out and do it all over again. Air blank. A-I-R. Thank you.
Bethany John is ready. You collect the $30,000 by matching him.
Conditioner.
You don't like that one, huh? Well, I don't know. Air conditioner is one. There may be something better. I have one in my mind. I don't know whether it's better or not, but it all depends on John. If he says air conditioner, then there's nothing better, is there? Okay, John.
There were so many good ones that I felt for you. This one was probably better than any, so I said Air Force.
Air Force. Airplane is another possibility.
There are a million of them.
Yeah.
Even air supply. Which
air pollution.
Air raid. But air raid, which ran through my mind.
Well, there's some outstanding and universal ones.
Yeah. To forgive divine.
Well, listen, it hasn't been a total loss for you so far. 2 days here, $7,600. That's not bad, Bethany. And you're still a champ, remember? And you're coming back tomorrow. We'll be back with our champ and the stars right after this. We've already revealed who had the big number, but the one thing John and I would like to do is to thank the stars for giving us
right.
a splendid week. We love you all, and you will all be back here another time. Well, not everybody. Not everybody. We're not going to draw lots exactly. No. No, you'll all be back. Thank you very much. And we'll see you on Monday, right, Bethany?
I will be here.
Jayne Rayburn inviting you to join us on Monday.
John Batman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares there. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive this KitchenAid mixer with attachments. Can handle most every task, from a single egg white to kneading yeast doughs. It's a complete food preparer furnished by KitchenAid. Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.